submandibular gland is enlarged.
I am a neuroradiologist, which means I focus on interpreting imaging studies of the brain, of the head and neck, so the ears, the nose, the throat, and the spine.
And then these scans here.
You really get the most value out of having someone who's specialty trained in a specific body part and those modalities that image that body part to interpret those scans. I feel like a detective every day, and you know, their images come up and I get excited, and I try to, you know, first just kind of get an overview of everything and then really kind of go through my systematic approach, and you know, don't stop until I think I've found the correct reason for their symptoms.
Surrounding inflammatory change.
You know, if I see something, I will just, you know, go across the hallway to my body imaging colleague and we'll basically consult back and forth with each other. I loved passing on the knowledge, and particularly for head and neck, it's kind of a small field, and I loved when I would just see sort of the light bulb go off in their head when they grasped a concept, or I would show them a case and they could, you know, instantly come up with a reasonable list of diagnoses. That was sort of a gift, I guess, back to me. I just loved when that happened.